Greetings, and welcome to Masterworks of Video Game Music. I'm your host, Count Lesser, and today we will be discussing one of the longest-running series of all video games, Castlevania, particularly when many consider to be the greatest game in the entire series, 1997's Castlevania Symphony of the Night. Oh, blood tastes terrible.
Ugh. Unlike previous Castlevania games, where the player assumes the role of a member of the Belmont clan, all legendary vampire hunters, Symphony of the Night's protagonist is Alucard, Dracula's half-human, half-vampire son, who has returned 300 years after the events of Castlevania Dracula's Curse. Symphony of the Night's original score was composed by Michiru Yamane, who had composed the music to 1994's Castlevania Bloodlines. Based on the success of Symphony of the Night, Yamane composed several subsequent Castlevania games, including Lament of Innocence, Aria of Sorrow, Curse of Darkness, Portrait of Ruin, and Order of Ecclesia. It is Yamane's soundtrack for Symphony of the Night in which she is most recognized, having written 34 original songs for the game. While her music has been described as old, gothic, and Victorian, one of Yamane's primary influences was the earlier music of Johann Sebastian Bach, on which she based her thesis during her time in college. This is particularly evident in the song Wood Carving Partita, played in the long library section, which imitates the style of the Baroque period using the sound of the harpsichord, a common instrument in Bach's time. This is also illustrated in the Royal Chapel area, where the pipe organ and vocal choir sound similar to a typical Baroque mass or oratorio, except of course for the darker undertones reflected in the fact that a church lies in a vampire's castle. In addition, the final toccata theme presented in the inverted castle is very similar to Bach's Toccata and Fugue in D minor. Yamane's compositional work for video games began with the Nintendo Entertainment System, which only had the capacity for 4 audio channels. The Sony PlayStation console that Symphony of the Night was designed for had a much more sophisticated setup, allowing Yamane to use sounds that very closely resembled real musical instruments. In fact, Yamane was even able to use a live guitarist and vocalist for certain parts of the soundtrack, such as in the clock tower section and the ending theme. One of the most defining features of Yamane's score to Symphony of the Night is the variety of musical influences that work seamlessly to convey the mood depending on the location of the castle the player is in. This is reflected not only on her interest in classically based composers such as Mozart, Beethoven, Chopin, Rachmaninoff, Ravel, and Debussy, but also more contemporary artists including Dream Theater, Kraftwerk, Yellow Magic Orchestra, and Ryuichi Sakamoto. The opening of the game is a brief prologue which uses the Dance of Illusion theme during the fight with Dracula that Yamane previously used in Castlevania Bloodlines. During the main game, music representing multiple genres are featured, including Gothic rock in the castle entrance section, classical in the alchemy laboratory, Victorian in Ulrox's quarters, jazz in the Colosseum, and heavy metal in the clock tower. Heavy metal is also featured prominently during many of the boss fights, which is labeled in the game's soundtrack as the Festival of Servants. Having never composed rock music prior to Symphony of the Night, Yamane's score is reminiscent of the Baroque style that defines the music of previous Castlevania games. Although similar, Yamane never directly copies these themes, including the famous Vampire Killer music from the first Castlevania, the Bloody Tears music from Castlevania II, Simon's Quest, or the first stage theme from Castlevania III, Dracula's Curse.
Yamane's score displays striking originality, but easily displays a kindred spirit to Symphony of the Night's predecessors. It is for these reasons why Castlevania Symphony of the Night remains one of the most iconic game soundtracks in history. Thanks so much for watching, and please comment below as to which game's music you would like me to discuss next. You can also subscribe to be notified of new videos as well. Until then, I'm Professor Lesser, and I'll see you next time. Oh, that's much better.